Okay, I'm not talking about some coffee breaks. Now I'm about to talk about some achievements and happiness, about my own experience and, as a matter of fact, about something I'm working right now. First of all, why? What is echo? I don't like it. Why I'm talking about it at all? As a matter of fact, I'm working in IT approximately 20 years and 15 years. In parallel, I'm making a kind of psychological observation of people, and it made me some kind of expert of user experience and usability. Right now, in our company, we are working on a solution to provide something to help people work and to organize. How it's related? Let's get through. First of all, small step aside, as a human being, I something want. What and why? Simple questions. Because why? I want to achieve more. It's good. Otherwise, where would be my individual progress, development? Why? Just because I want. That's fine. And I really want to feel better, or at least the same as now. All of us, I hope, think this way. That's human. How to make it? Sounds like really simple questions and maybe even strange. Get more done and focus on my emotional feelings and well-being. Where's the problem? The problem is, somehow, we see mostly that doing and achieving more means do more things. I've done 5 things today. To get more, I need to done 6 things, 7, 8, 20. Where's the limit? When I die. That's the old limit. The different way how we like to talk about is, let's be more efficient. Sounds like big stuff's guy. Talk, talk, talk. Who's gonna work? But there's the answer. In one way, I can do really a different thing simultaneously. As a fact, I'm so efficient. And in different approach, I can arrange them and focus on one thing. Some maybe already know the term of flow. When you really feel and enjoy things you do, you are at the peak of your efficiency and having fun of what you do. I'm not yet something new to tell to you, because we already have a lot of methodologies covering all this stuff. Yes. Now the question, do you are familiar with getting things done, Agile Results or Asian Efficiency? Who are familiar with? Please, raise your hands. Okay, great. At least one is more than enough. It's just to get familiar. And how you know in the point of enjoyment, technologies of positive psychology for the work, strengths-based development and appreciate inquiry? Not so much. And the catch there is quite simple. Those things greatly talk about how to get things happen. And they're really efficient about it. Here we have great, really great methodologies and methods and steps how to make us feel good, calm. And almost nobody talks about the simplest thing, how those could go together. Somehow we are missing the point. We know how to work till we die, and we know how to stop and enjoy the life. But somehow our daily routine is not this way. Okay, maybe we work, stop, enjoy. Work, stop, enjoy. Something is not working quite nice as it should be. So one is just to results, another is just to feeling. But how to cover both of those things? How to be emotionally great? As a matter of fact, I can make a visualization. I think most of all are familiar with some kind of way of plants with zombies. I'm thanking them. It's from them taking this picture. I would say must versus want. I think I must do this. As a matter of fact, I want to feel, enjoy this. And mostly people have those a concurrency moment. And those parts are like fighting each other. I have to do more to have something to enjoy. I have to enjoy to be able to carry on. Both sides looks like a war. And the most interesting thing is recruits are coming daily. Both sides are getting stronger and stronger. And whoever wins is just one thing to be certain. Battlefield is gonna suffer. The battlefield, us. Something doesn't sound so good. So probably it's time to think some quite a simple thing. Yes. Let's mix them together. How? No, first of all, let's see how we are looking at it. First thing, what I already heard today, I was yesterday thinking, will it be heard today or not? It was. Mostly, we really know how to work as a team, how to help team, how to enjoy as a team, how to team. When it comes to enjoyment, sorry, there's no team. At the end of the day, there are only me. And inside, there's only me. When I say, okay, I did it and we feel great. But at the evening, when you are at home and I'm at home, it's anyway me. When I'm stop saying loud, it's me. So, effective, but not at any cost. There's one small difference and I'll come back. You see, the Agile Results as an efficiency is really popular in Asian region, as a matter of fact. And they're really good at sticking in and getting things done more and more. It's amazing. Also, not so nice and amazing in that suicide rate in this region is highest in the world. Something doesn't sound too good to me. Maybe it's just coincidence, but also some analysis shows that it's not quite nice as it should be. So, I'm not about to be efficient at any cost, and I would not recommend to anyone. Next thing that's already also today was mentioned is no methodology could be just taken and applied. There's always the current situation and current approach as you have to adopt it, and then it will work. You don't use anything. And if you are at peak of your efficiency, it just doesn't mean you'll be at just a little happy. Be efficient doesn't mean being happy. It's not the equal. Yes, efficiency can make you to happiness, but there's a small tricks. And for human being, emotional well-being is everything. Yes, if we say we want to career, it's not the emotional well-being. Why we want career? Why we want something to happen? Because it makes us feel good. Yes, maybe we are not ready to say it to anyone, but as a matter of fact, all what we do is just to feel good. Sorry, that's the nature of people. Let's not fight it. Let's make it to work for us, for ourselves. So, let's get it step by step through. Easy and fast. First of all, I need to understand where I am. And that's the way what I recommend for each who is about to do it. Think about yourself, not about a group, team, company, neighbor, friend. Think as I think, not we, I. I now is the right word. What I'm good at? Oh yes, we can make a list. But truly, how to understand it. There's three different small steps. There's more, but three. First of all, my own opinion, most untrusted source, because I'll be trying to be good about myself. Second, quite nice, is a small interviews. It's part of appreciating queries, what they are proposing and it working. A simple situation. As a matter of fact, I would ask someone to stand and come with me, and I'll tell this person the story I was great at, really success in my opinion. I just tell the story. I don't tell about myself. I tell the story. Approximately 5-7 minutes. That's enough. Then I'll ask this person to provide a feedback. What he or she heard from me, I was doing great. Where I was at my peak of efficiency. And I'll mark those words. Then I'll make next and next, so get through multiple such situations and you'll get a list of points where you're really strong. And maybe you even don't notice it. Third version that is also working quite good, can be done by alone, but always partner is good. Get through approximately past 2 years and see what you have succeeded, achieved. And they try to understand why, what helped your own characteristics, what helped. There's also another technique. Those three is good enough for starting. Now, the next step, what is most important, I remind, now we feeling, okay, we have list of our strengths. Okay, what to do with it? It's not about make me happy just being strong. Maybe someone, but most of us, I don't think so. Now imagine the world is perfectly as you can see. What, nothing can go wrong. Nothing is against you. Everything is just you can imagine. But no limitations at all. And I'll say, how you see the world? What you are doing? What is your day? Everything is perfect. You can't say, yes, I'm doing, but there's no but. No limitations. Then describe it to someone. And try to describe it that way to make a measurement. Make it describe this way that this person at some moment can say, hey, you see, the situation has changed so it's perfectly as you told me. Make it measurable for yourself. Just doing it with paper and pen working quite hardly. When we're trying to verbalize, we are really making it more precise. And sometimes other person can just ask us questions and we realize, okay, yes, but I meant it this way. If we're going through this and we can, as a matter of fact, do it quite fast, now we are having list strengths and our ideal world where we'll be happy. Now it's about to make things how to do it. No, let's put those lists aside. Forget about it. It was first thing that looked like got a day, agile results. Stop. Now let's concentrate on different lists. As a matter of fact, first part was more about zombies. Now let's talk about flowers. Moments of joy. We already mentioned this part. And now let's see what exactly you were doing while you are enjoying. List such things. Again, short, quick list. It's important. Test them. In simplest way, imagine it's happening again. Is it joyful? Do you like it? Or, okay, that was one-time experience. I'm not gonna do it again. Thank you. So make a list of things you'd like to have. Next thing, list could be quite short, unfortunately. Try to enlarge it, find new things. It's not so easy, I'm not gonna tell it today the full methodology of this, but as example, there's book How of Happiness, it's one of the best I can recommend. In materials, there will be a bit more about it mentioned. There's first, third part is quite hard, but then it comes to the exact steps, how to understand what could make you feel better, feel more happy. Really, it's quite realistic. And what maybe you already seen, having partner in this process helps. Because alone, it's hard because we so easily start to lie to ourselves. We try to be better, look smarter. I'm not this way. Yes, I am. I need this strength to tell. Yes, I am this way. I don't care about this. Sorry. Sorry for who? I not yet don't know. Okay, it's fine to me. But I really care about this. Nobody cares, but I care. I try and find other, but main thing now, I have two lists. First list, so achieve, where to get, and next things listed, what makes me happy, what makes me feel good, enjoy, what makes me happy about in the morning to seeing yes the next day starting, not yes again. Problem is those lists doesn't mix together, they're apart. Now we need to make them together. First thing, just because there are things everyone is saying that we need to do, it's required from us, we can't change that. Yes, okay, I'm not fighting it. As a matter of fact, it's not quite true, but let's stick with this. We can't change things, fine, with me. Analyze those things. Make a one thing you said to achieve and list of joy and make relations. What could be joyful in this process and get through both of those lists this way. It's important. Now, when you have mapped those things together, rethink, please, first list of achievements. Look at the achievements which doesn't make any way you more happy. And rethink, do you really need them? There will be such things. If you really made at least half complete list, there will be. I can give such a simple sample. Some people learn to be bachelors or magisters or even doctors. Why? Okay, some really are in science, but some are because they feel pushed of the friends, family, everybody in family has degree. I also had to. And what joy is in this for you? I'll have, okay, what you have. My friend will clap and say, great. 5 seconds of joy after 6 years at the university? Maybe I can buy him a beer and he'll clap me. It will be less costly. Do you really need to dig on those things? Because a social life thinks that's right for you. Don't. Or just rethink. Sometimes we can't change. It means we are not ready to change. Then we can try to find moments of joy. Because we know, okay, it's been 4 years, but at least 2 times a month, we are having a great meeting. We are learning new things. Aha! This achievement is hard, but I find a moment of joy. Okay, this list still may be not looking too good for you, but it's already listed. You start understanding when you can enjoy. I'll return to this point. Third point is add new goals, what you want to achieve. Why? Just to have fun. Now question for Autori. Who has any kind of hobby? Thanks. And now question to you. All who said about having hobbies, do you have exact goals for those hobbies? Not bad, but not everyone yet. I'm really great about feeling great about you. That's a great way how to pay attention to those things. It's important. Otherwise, we put those things just aside. When we have time, okay, we proceed. We'll be happy, okay, when we'll have time. Great. What I don't want, some time ago I really said it when I was changing my job. I said, I don't want on my tombstone a writing. This person lived a really great and beautiful job. I want something about my life, not about my job. So try to see those things a bit different. If you are feeling already okay, it may be not so important to you, but those steps help to make a mixed list of achievements you think must and things that make you happy, that makes you want another day to come so you can do things that makes you joyful. Okay, we have list. List now could be a bit large. So how are we about the time? Time is running. First of all, let's quickly sort it out so we can focus on things. As a matter of fact, it's really hard hard to work simultaneously on 50 different things. It's just not putting in head. That's what talking, getting things done, as an efficiency and other. So you have to have focus. So first of all, let's sort the level. It comes from getting things done. Lifetime, 5 years, shorter. That's important. Next is priorities of the goals. What you see is more important because most probably, as we know from IT projects, and life is almost the same as such projects, we have to lose something in the process. We are not going to achieve everything. That's just not going to happen. 30% is already quite fine mostly. It's good enough for most of the projects. And when we have such a prioritization, we see what we want, what we short-term, long-term, it first good feeling. You can see the map that says we are about to feel good. Fine. When you last time have seen such list? List that says you're going to feel good. I like such list. I also having it really rarely. Next, set exact tasks what you're about to do. Otherwise, it's not to work. But that's about the methodologies that already is talking about it. What I already told you, find a balance. It means you have to spend some time to enjoy the life. You can't just, okay, I did everything, why I'm not feeling happy? That's why. So it works. But this time could be really, really short. I'll give you an example. When you are completing a task approximately, example, for 3 days, and this task was something you like to do, make a pause, stop for 2 minutes before rushing to next task where colleagues already you help, we have a problem. Make this small, small pause to enjoy, see, yes, this was good. Okay, what you was about? And these small steps, as example, 3 times a day already makes you feel better. So simple, but almost not yet covered mostly. Now, have list, do it. About the pause I already told you. Next small thing, what is helping, really helping, when you start something new, maybe reverse and look back. What you have achieved, what was good. Your strengths is, okay, I did that. Oh, I gonna complete this also and then enjoyed it. Okay, so again this, it's a lot. It's 3 months, it will be hard. Wait a minute. That's quite a different approach and really results vary. If you see why you are good, why you can, it really helps to achieve and go on. About making retrospectives. Most commonly, those are dropped out because we are short on time, we need to run, jump. No, it's important to learn, to be more efficient about ourselves. Retrospectives could be quite short in time. It doesn't require make this way. And second part is don't make classic Latvian criticism. I'm sorry if others don't understand. I'll make a small notice about it. Latvian criticism means say everything bad you can find, and that's it. Good retrospective means what happened, ignore why. Second, what to do to good and great things happen again, and what to do to bad things just don't happen again. That's it. If you feel emotional, you still need to search why and who, okay, but it's not going to help you. Those two parts are great, other is not. And one thing that some people, mostly like me, could be having a problem is analytical approach. We need to make a retrospective. I jumped skydiving, I lost my shoes. What to do to don't lose shoes while I'm skydiving? I'm not going to skydive again. I don't need to solve this problem. So, problem solved. Retrospective short. Oh yes, and about adjustment, what is most important that comes from the waterfall and mainly whatever we can love, but in Agile also it tries to reappear as a kind of zombie, is stick to the plans, go straight forward. That's right. And also write these change plans. Don't change daily your yearly and lifetime plans. It's not going to help you. But also, once in a year, change lifetime plans just to review its client wise. And month's plan to be adjusted maybe once a week or just retrospective. Okay, it's fine. Let's keep doing this way. Maybe otherwise it's not yet more important. So be adjustable, and also what makes teams also feeling good, it's trust to the business if business sticks to the decisions. And this is the way how we see ourselves also. If we stick to our decisions and proceed, even if we are panicking, oh, maybe not. Fine, I'll review it in a month. Now I'm just going straight forward. Why? Just because to get there. Tools. Quite simple. First of all, most important, paper and pen. Why? If you already have something more intelligent, stick with it, but nobody is yet, I have seen, been available to avoid such things. Some things that's really working, I have seen for people, OmniFocus, AnyDo, Asana, there's a lot more others. It's for task planning. It really helps. One source of things you have to do, not three, not Jira, Redmine, OmniFocus, Inbox, no, that's a mess. Try to make it in one place. It will help. It's not about enjoyment, it's just about keeping it simple and straightforward. Notes, Evernote or Microsoft OneNote, whoever maybe you other using, but one thing I could recommend already, think about who you'll be sharing notes with. If it's notes just for you, do it whatever you want. Maybe even a Photoshop is good for you for notes, fine. But if you're about sharing notes, try to reach understanding, because it's not so nice if I have OneNote, you have Evernote, someone else. We are starting running around, not for team. And as I mentioned before, you most probably want to have a partner to discuss with. And maybe it will be not one partner, but multiple. I am fine to talk with you about fishing, but I'm not talking about family. You have two divorces. About you, I'm quite really nice to talking about family. You know the thing I want to hear from you, that's fine, but I need to sharing with those guys. Otherwise, it's not gonna work. As I mentioned before, book How of Happiness by Sonia Lyubomirsky, really recommend, good one. This was quite quickly. There's a lot more detail. We are now working on the product to solve all this together. So, if you want to discuss more than today, there will be questions also now. Or maybe even you and your company want to be one of the first customers, you are welcome to contact me. We can discuss it. But now about enjoying the life. Questions? Yes?
What if this mapping of must do and can't do gets you into prison?
Example.
I don't want to share it.
Oh, I'm not the one you want to share with. I would strongly recommend maybe some smarter consultant. In Latvia, it's not so popular to consult a psychotherapist. It doesn't mean you are crazy. No, it may be a problem with priorities. Most of us may have hard times setting such priorities. Or you have good friend to talk with. Because while you are sitting alone and trying to make list, this list could make, kill this guy, kill those guys. Yes, that's not, and I'm enjoying the idea of this. Yes.
I add new points to legislation.
But maybe you, as a matter of fact, not wanting to have those guys eliminated, there's reasons why. And those reasons may be solved a different way. So just change your point of view. It doesn't mean the list is wrong. As a matter of fact, list is never wrong because it's your list. And if anyone says it's wrong, ignore him.
So in Africa, the two guys in Africa, it's correct, right?
I didn't say that. No list is wrong. I didn't say the actions is right.
Sounds like it's making the
form illegal.
And what's wrong?
You were the expert.
As a great example, as a matter of fact. Really, great example. Okay,
well,
find another company.
Well, usually to be called a hacker, you have to be like caught once being a hacker. Otherwise, you're just an expert.
Yes. The situations.
I don't know, I'm not a hacker.
I know how much you are a developer. I can be in the
Okay.
I start to go to the war more and more.
Oh. If they are happy, they could maybe some other goals they are not going to achieve. They maybe want to live another 40 or 50 years, and they would be a problem with achievements.